joining us from Arizona.
Simple by number.
Hey, hi. I'm Dr. Saul Azuz, and I'm here from Mayo Clinic in Arizona. I'm chief resident in plastic surgery and a biomedical engineer, and I'd like to show you my nipples. Here they are. So in 2017 alone, there were over 250,000 cases of breast cancer. Of those, almost 100,000 women underwent mastectomy. And in the past 10 years, there's been almost 1 million women who have undergone mastectomy. What does that mean? It's removal of the breast parenchyma and the nipple areolar complex. And how do we reconstruct that as plastic surgeons? Well, we do a very good job reconstructing the breast mound, that is, with implants or flaps. But as you can see here, on the right is a breast. On the left is a breast mound. That is not a breast. What defines a breast is the nipple areolar complex. So how is the nipple areolar complex made? Well, it's made most commonly nowadays with a 3D tattoo. Unfortunately, these tattoos are highly variable and often done unsupervised by non-medical professionals. This is an example of a 3D tattoo done freehand by an allied health professional. Our solution is a nipple by number, a paint by number approach to reconstructing the nipple areolar complex. It is clean, disposable, customizable for each patient, and can be 3D printed, cost effective when injection molded. And how much does tattooing cost? Well, we did a survey of over 750 plastic surgery offices, and the out-of-pocket cost to patient for a unilateral tattoo was $640 and $1,000 for a bilateral. The market size, well, this is potentially a $35 million a year business. And finally, how are we gonna deliver this? Well, there's already business-to-business models through the big implant manufacturers, that being Allergan and Mentor, Johnson & Johnson, or a direct-to-provider scenario where kits are made and distributed to plastic surgery offices. Thank you very much, and I'm happy to answer any questions.
So there are instances of moving the aesthetics non-regulated procedures to provider, to medical professionals that result in pretty extensive cost bumps for patients. Because now you either need nursing or MD staff to perform those procedures.
Sure.
That would normally be done by non-regulated staff or lightly regulated staff.
Yes.
Is that tolerable to the patient?
Yeah, so that 750 market it comes from people doing this already. That being said, I'll just clarify the level of professionalism. Right now, they're being done in downtown Phoenix, for example, in a tattoo parlor. We want to get them back in the office. It doesn't mean the MD has to be doing the tattoo themselves, but at least it will be supervised by having them doing it in the provider's office, and that wouldn't add any cost necessarily.
So in Minnesota, for instance, tattoo parlors have gotten to the point where you no longer need to wait after a tattoo for blood training, for a blood donation. So they're in many states, they're well-regulated industries. So that, again, is that you're taking, maybe adding 10x to the cost of a tattoo done in the parlor at the MD's office?
I mean, I don't think so. We've talked to a lot of tattoo parlors. They charge $500,
okay.
Sometimes $1,000. That being said, I would argue that if your grandmother had breast cancer, I wouldn't want to send her down to a tattoo parlor where the guy next door is a biker getting a nipple on his arm. I'd rather have the patient more comfortable in a plastic surgeon's office.
How's your VOC borne that out?
How's your
voice of customer borne that out?
Yes, our customers have borne that out.
Are you also proposing to use different or better inks, for instance, that would be more durable or visible?
Yes, and so that's a very good point, and that's a reason not to go to the tattoo parlor, is that they're using often non-medical grade inks. We would be using medical grade inks that tend to last longer.
So when you pointed out the example, though, of the freehand having been done, and that
yes.
was done by a professional.
That was done by unsupervised freehand allied health.
So is the magic here this, that allows people, I'll say, not to color outside the lines, or is
yes.
the magic here the ink or the service level based on the professionalism for all people?
I'd say a little bit of all the above, but I would say following the directions and coloring in the lines is extremely important.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.